falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus was the best thing I've ever done.
And the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known.
Good evening. Welcome again to Falling in Love with Jesus with Sue. We're going to continue with last week, and this is just another part of Call Unto Me and I Will Answer. And of course, we're talking about the Lord. But before I go into our lesson or whatever you want to call it, teaching or just reminding us that God is and the way, the truth, and I like to say the life, but He is our life. And in life, we move and we have and we be. So I'm going to give my grandson, who is only 3 years old, he was just desperate to want to say something. So he wants you to know what the Lord has given him, and he wants to say it. So guess what? The Bible says out of the mouth of babes. So I'm going to let him tell you what his name is, and then he wants to sing this little song that he said the Lord has given him. Okay? What's your name?
Joshua.
And what's the song you sing?
ABC.
Okay, but why don't you go ahead and sing it?
ABCDEFGHIJKLMNOPQRS-T-U-V-W-X-Y-Z.
Okay, and who taught you that song?
Jesus.
Okay, so next time I will sing that with you. After I get off the recording, I'll sing that song with you. And we just thank the Lord for little Joshua. But Heavenly Father, we're going to go ahead and pray. We pray tonight that your day has gone well. We pray that the Lord will come in the room and be with us and give us what to say, just how to say it. We are all experiencing unknown and unforeseen conditions in our world. So we ask the Lord to just continue to send us a river that will flow through our lives, through our families, through our communities, and just give us a mind and a heart to continue to look to the hills from whence cometh our help, because all of our help comes from Thee and Thee alone. And we just thank Him for His saving grace that will flow into the lives of those that don't know Him in the pardon of their sins. We just thank You for it in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen.
Amen.
Okay, now, last week we ended up with talking about faith, and we know, and if you don't know, we know that faith is the substance. Yes, faith is the substance of things hoped for. Our substance is in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and our evidence is we don't have to see it. And in order to hear from God, we must come to Him by faith. And that is so true, because if you don't believe Him, there's no way you're going to come to Him. Again, like we were saying last week, you're not going to come to Him unless you believe that He is real. And if you can't believe that, then there's no way that you'll be able to receive His saving grace. So we want to be able to trust in the Lord. And again, if you can't believe it, there's no way you'll be able to trust in Him with all thy heart, because you will be leaning like the Bible says, to your own understanding, your own logic. And so this is certainly the way we come to him, by trusting him and not leaning to what we think or what we believe. We have to put all that away, in a sense, the way we think or the way we thought about something in our own logic of belief. We have to put that away and begin to trust in him with all our heart, not just some of our heart, because faith is what helps us to get to God, to get to the Trinity, to get to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And this is why I have accepted him, and accepting him, I discovered in my life he's real. The Bible tells us in Psalms 119 and 105 that his word is like a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. It wasn't until I began to walk with him through this, how could I say, this light is just a presence. And it's like he has helped me to be enlightened with the things that I had no understanding about. So, and I just, like I said, believed him. The Bible says, blessed are they who have not seen and yet believe. And that is so powerful, because when you can come into an awareness, no matter what, I'm going to believe him. Whether I've seen, none of us have seen God, but whether I see something happening in my life or not, I'm just going to believe him because of what his word says. And when you come into that awareness, then you truly are walking in faith. And we just thank the Lord for those that have decided to, you know, have faith to come into the kingdom of God and to begin to learn of him. So it's just truly a blessing, because when you think about it, where would you be today if it had not been for the Lord on your side? If you had not come into awareness of knowing that there is someone greater than anything in this world that is a present help in the time of trouble. Truly, we certainly thank the Lord. And that's just a wonderful, wonderful way of being, knowing that there's someone greater than yourself, that when you find yourself in situations that you just don't understand, there is someone that you can talk to and you can cast your cares on him, because we know that he certainly cares for us. It's not just about the material things. You know, being blessed, yes, you will come into a lot of material things, but they that know the Lord, I mean, we know that there is most certainly more than just having material things. You need him to be a lawyer. You need him to be a doctor. You need him to be your teacher. I mean, whatever it is, he is that present help. And I don't want to discover him by tempting him, like, well, I'm not going to believe until he showed me something. And this is most how some people may be. You know, I don't want to know until I discover what I can't see, and then I'll consider coming to Christ. But I don't want to wait until something happens and then all of a sudden, now I want to know you. I want to know him before my storms in life come. See, this is why God gives us mercy, because he knows the human mind cannot discover without him. So he gives us this opportunity as we go through life, and as we go through different difficulties in life, he will give us the opportunity to come to him, because we most certainly see that, you know, this thing is not working out. I keep going around and around this mountain, and I just don't understand you know, how this mountain can be moved in a sense. And maybe sometimes that mountain, you don't need to try to move it, but he gives us the grace and mercy to climb that mountain, in a sense, the mountains and storms in life. But because our human mind cannot discover how to do these things without God, we cannot explain some of the things that go on in life. That's really my point. And it's the inner workings. And without the Trinity, without the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we cannot explain the will of God. And only He can allow us to know. He is the one that orders our steps. He is the one that will help us to see His riches and in His wisdom. And this only comes through Him. Yes, I got my little grandson with me, and he keeps trying to figure out, can he get back on to record? We'll get him something later on. But again, where was I? God's wisdom. And we do most certainly want to know His wisdom and His knowledge and His understanding. But the only way, we got to have faith to come to Him and to believe that He is, and accept. We want to understand this doctrine of the gospel of the kingdom of God. We got to come just like a child. You know, sometimes, you know, my mama used to say, you just too grown to understand. You too grown to learn something new. Sometimes we get into that way. You know, I've been there, done that, and I know all this and I know all that. I think we need to take that, you know, well, I do, take that out of my vocabulary. I know, because I don't know anything except the Lord reveal it to me. Yes, I'm not saying the basic common sense and things of that nature, but sometimes there are things that we really don't know, and all we need to do is just tell the Lord, I don't know. I don't know how I'm going to make this. I don't know how I'm going to get through this. I really don't know what I'm doing. I don't know how to be a mother. I don't know how to be a father. I don't know how to be a sister. I don't know how to be a brother. I don't know. I don't know. Lord, will you help me? And that takes a broken and contrite spirit. And sometimes this is where we have to be. And I hear the Lord saying some of us right now are dealing with something that is really, really a stronghold. And we really are not looking to even get through it. Maybe we've thrown our hands up and said, you know, enough is enough. I don't want to deal with this anymore, or I'm getting ready to make a decision. Just stop. I'm getting ready to make a decision, and I don't really have all the facts. I don't really have all the information, and I'm not at peace with what I'm about to enter into. I'm about to take this job that may send me somewhere I really don't have any peace about it. Well, I want you to know right now, you can discover that God is a present help in the time of trouble, and He will come and He will give you an answer. But you got to wait on Him. You got to be patient. You know, let patience have its perfect work. I guarantee you, if you go to the Lord and you begin to call upon the name of the Lord, He will answer. And, you know, sometimes we spend a lifetime trying to prove there is no God. Sometimes we spend a lifetime trying to prove there is no God, because sometimes we've been to church, we've grown up in the church, we was raised in the church, and maybe some things in your life did not turn out the way you thought it would be. Well, my question is this: did you really, really try Him? Whomsoever you may be, you must accept Him, accept His word, and the meaning that only comes through His word. He said, learn of me, take my yoke. And sometimes we take people's yoke and we yoke up with what they think and what they believe. Well, God is a God that will come to you, a personal relationship you can have with him. But you got to trust him. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Anything that has gone on in our lives or whatever our lives have become, we have to take the responsibility of it, because God has got a relationship with each individual. He said, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that he is Lord. So in order to say that there is no God because I tried him and I've been walking with him or what have you, then prove me, the Lord says. Prove to see who I am. And that's what you have to do. You have to go and try everything that you can possibly think of that by reading the Bible. I'm going to obey this. Reading the Bible, I'm going to obey that. You got to do a sacrifice. In other words, present your body a living sacrifice. I am going to live my life today under his tutelage, and I'm going to obey everything that he speaks in my heart to do. Everything that he speaks in my heart to do. I ain't no half-stepping. See, a lot of times we won't say, oh, there is no God because I tried him this way, that way, and this way. Have you allowed him to come into every compartment of your heart in your life? Have you presented your body a living sacrifice? And the only way you can begin to do that, you got to ask him to come in, and he will help you to live a sacrificial life. And he will begin to show you the baptism of the Holy Spirit that will keep you, that will lead you, that will guide you. And God is your reasonable sacrifice. In other words, he has given us grace to run the race that's set before us, and we look to Jesus, who is your author and finisher of your faith. He's going to orchestrate your life. He is going to lead you and guide you into the destiny that he has already predestined for you before you were shaped and formed in your mother's womb. But you have to have faith. And faith gives way to belief. Belief gives way to God revealing to you. It is called giving you a revelation about what it is you need to do or you need to know. And nobody can do you like the Lord. Nobody can do that but the Lord. So I pray that you will begin to call up on him and begin to see what it is that he has for you, saved or unsaved. He said, call unto me. Today, if you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Today is the acceptable year, day, moment, hour, minute of the Lord. It is his time and it is your time to seek him and call him, because he cares for you. He loves you and he's waiting for you.
Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus was the best thing I've ever done.